But it doesn't matter because she somehow figured out who she is. And the next day, she decides to confront her. It turns out as badly as you would think it would.
Brenda, when I made those calls, I needed somebody to talk to. And I was there for you. Yes, you were, but on the other end of the line where I didn't have to see you and you didn't know who I was. And you changed that. If you tell anybody what I said to you, if you break your promise to me, I'll make you sorry. Look, Bonnie, I know what you're going through. You're a sophomore. You want to be popular and you want the popular guys to go out with you. Shut up. But it's not worth it. Shut up! Can't you see they're just using you? You're jealous. You're jealous because you're a nobody at the school. And I gotta go. Bonnie!
Back in the land of men who can't get laid, Brandon talks with the older woman, Nina, and things get interesting.
And what I'm learning now is the best possible therapy you could ever do for your skin tone. It's called an herbal wrap.
What's that?
Well, it's a natural way to detoxify your system and remineralize your entire body.
Really?
Mm-hmm. It is so great. First, you get a massage with all the essential oils, like sage and juniper. And then you get wrapped in plastic.
Really?
And then we cover your entire body with these thick, hot, steaming towels.
Really?
And then you take a hot shower. And we rub in all the creams.
So Brandon goes to her place expecting sex, and instead gets a bit of a surprise.
Richard? I thought I heard someone.
Hi, sweetie.
Hi. That night, at the end of the pep rally...
Last event?
Hey, we're just saving the best for last, right? Co-ed tug-of-war has always been my specialty.
Way to go, Sanders!
Hey, couldn't have done it without you guys tugging on the rope. Hey, what are you guys doing tonight?
Oh, you know, just doing some raping. The scumbags try to pull this shit again. When?
Hey, please! Now! People! And put your hands in the air!
But how did the cops know when to bust them?
I knew this was gonna happen like this.
All the calls came after 10. So your sister figured that, these attacks might be taking place after each grudge night event.
What is she, Nancy fucking Drew? The funniest episode, though, has got to be the alcohol abuse episode. It's called BYOB. And it starts simple enough when Brandon and Brenda go to a party. Whoa! What the fuck is that on her head? Moving on. It turns out that at this party, they're serving alcohol. Brandon, at first, just says no. But Steve spikes his drink. Why are you friends with this guy again? Anyway, when Brendan finds out, he gets all ticked off. But then backs down and decides that it's okay and starts drinking. The following morning, the parents announce they're going to go away for the weekend, leaving the house in their hands. Of course! What could go wrong? We're only leaving the house in the hands of two teenagers. Of course, Brendan throws a party and the kids trash their house. Brandon has now become an alcoholic after one night of drinking, and the booze turns him into a clumsy, horny, bad-acting slush of a man. The situation only gets worse when they run low on liquor, and Steve, of all people, has a brilliant idea to go get some more at the store. You can guess what happens next. Okay, I'm not trying to make fun of drunk driving, but you gotta admit, that's fucking hilarious. Look at his face. Let's see that again. Okay, I just don't get tired of this. Let's see it one more time. Anyway, his parents bail him out, and they have the stupidest reaction to him almost killing himself while drunk driving.
Look, let's just go home and get some sleep, and we can talk about this later.
That sounds like a plan.
himself. He could have killed somebody else. And you guys are just all nonchalant, like, no big deal? What the fuck, man? Oh, no, but check out their reaction to the party.
That's the last time I throw a party.
Party? What party?
What a mess. This house is a wreck.
What happened here?
I invited a few friends. And it got a little out of hand.
A little out of hand? You and your friends trashed this place.
The stains aren't gonna come out, Brenda.
Dad, they weren't my friends.
Well, they were at our house, without our permission, drinking beer and wine and whatever else you were serving.
We weren't serving anything. 150 extra people showed up at the same time. Some of the guys brought liquor. What were we supposed to do?
Lock the door!
Is that what you and your friends did when you went on your beer runs?
No, we went back to our frat house. We didn't go to our parents' house when they were out of town.
Look, Dad.
No, you look. You look me in the eye and tell me how are we ever supposed to trust you kids again? We can't go out of town for a lousy vacation.
Well, Brandon winds up fessing up. And in the end, Dylan takes him to an Alcoholics Anonymous meeting, which is never talked about again. And that's Beverly Hills 90210. What a piece of crap. It's stupid, it insults our intelligence, and frankly, I'm amazed it lasted 10 fucking seasons! At least you guys didn't have to sit through an entire season of this like I did. Well, thank God there's no show that's worse than 90210. Speaking of which, let me see what my boss sent me for my next assignment.
Over the line, so he's home to the dark of all his right. Now only time will tell.